Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Akira. I'm a pianist, piano teacher, and a translator who lived in three different countries. Today I'm going to introduce a new addition to my studio, which is iPad Pro. If you're a loyal subscriber, you might be thinking, Akira, you already had an iPad Pro. Yes, I had an iPad Pro, but now I bought an
iPad Pro.
Yep, these are same things. Why did I buy a new one? Because there are some problems with my old iPad Pro. So today I'm going to talk about what the problem was and how I like the new iPad Pro. Before I start, I'd like to say huge thank you to all my patrons who signed up on my Patreon page. With your help, I'm getting closer and closer to being able to make these videos more often. And if you're willing to give up one cup of coffee each month to support this channel, please check out my Patreon page. So about a year ago, I started noticing something a little funny. I was playing at the church one day and I started noticing my iPad screen's not as bright as it used to be. So I increased the brightness and it was close to 100% already. At the time, I was just thinking, well, this is already 3 years old, maybe the screen's getting a little darker, that's normal. But then I started noticing that on the edge of my screen, there's one bright line and then the rest is dark. You can actually see it in this thumbnail. By the way, as you can tell, this video explains how I use my iPad to read sheet music from, and I actually perform with it. So if you're interested in that, please check out this video. So now I can clearly tell there's something wrong with the screen, but it was still functional. I thought it was okay. But then I started noticing my battery started going a little quicker than normal. It's not draining like crazy, but it was going much quicker than I remember. But again, I was thinking, well, it's 3 years old, maybe the battery's draining a little quicker, but no problem. But then a few months later, one day I was teaching, and my iPad all of a sudden just shuts down. Yep, black screen. Nothing. I was able to turn it back on, and it worked perfectly after that. But then I thought it was really weird. If that was just one incident, that would have been okay. But then it started happening maybe every couple weeks or so. If you watch my first iPad video, the reason I was able to use iPad for performance was because I knew it was very reliable. But now my screen's doing something weird and the battery's draining a little quicker, and then all of a sudden, it shuts down. So I could no longer trust it with my performances. It would be very unprofessional of me to use a device that I know is not 100% reliable for my performances. But at the time, fortunately or unfortunately, I didn't have any performance opportunities because of the viruses going on. So I was able to save up some money to buy a new device. Then about a month ago, the pastor from the church where I used to accompany regularly called me and asked me to come back for services. And at the same time, I got an inquiry for performances at an event. I went from zero booking to frequent performances all of a sudden. So now it was time for decision. Do I have to buy a new iPad? Or should I switch to Android? Like I said in my last video, I've been in this unhealthy relationship with my iPad all this time. I love how it works perfectly for my needs, but it's so expensive. And Apple gives you only one choice if you needed the bigger screen, which is a top of the line iPad Pro. It's a fantastic and powerful device. You can even edit videos on it, which I don't. You can play exciting games with fantastic graphic on it, which I don't. For what I do with iPad, any tablet can do. But if you wanted a bigger screen, you gotta pay up. Samsung actually has 12.9-inch Android tablet for a much, much cheaper price. Unlike when I did the research for the first time, there has been a lot of good apps that's been developed for Android for music reading. And because I'm a Windows and Android user, this would have been perfect device for me.
Except,
you cannot transfer your sheet music from iPad to Android very easily. The Foursquare app that I use and I love is not on Android. And it stores the music in certain format. So in order for me to go from Foursquare to Android app, I have to export everything in PDF file. And when I switched from Windows computer to iPad, some of the marking couldn't be transferred correctly. So I still see some weird markings here and there on some of my music. On top of that, my nicely organized bookmarks and playlists won't be transferred to the new app. So I had to start from scratch again. So reluctantly, I made my decision to stay with this gorgeous, beautiful, expensive iPad. So here's my message to Foursquare developers. Please, please, please make Android version. One good news about all of this was when I called Apple Store, they said my old iPad Pro might be eligible for trading. But in order to find out if it's a good enough condition to trade in and how much I can get out of it, I had to go to Apple Store. So I made an appointment. When I got there, after waiting a little bit, even though I made an appointment, I was met by a very nice iPad specialist, whose name I don't remember. Let's call him Carlos. So I showed Carlos my old iPad Pro. And he started checking it out and checked the serial number and the casing and everything. And during that time, my heart was pounding. And I was like, please don't notice the screen. And he didn't. He said my iPad was functional and I was eligible for $260. So now instead of $1,000, I only had to pay $740. For which you can probably buy the Samsung tablet without trading. That even comes with a stylus. But at the last moment, he said we have a slight problem here. We don't have the one you want in stock. And the only one we have is next level up. But that model was the same model with twice more storage and $100 more. The lowest storage capacity you can have is 128GB, which is about already twice more than I need anyway. But I definitely didn't want to pay $100 more for twice more storage, which I don't need, along with many other features that comes with this iPad. This is where I would normally say, hey, it's not my fault that you guys don't have the one I want in stock. Can you meet me in the middle? But I knew Apple wouldn't do that, so I didn't even ask. Or would they? See what the fancy storefront did? It stopped an Asian person from negotiating. So I had two options there. One is to leave my iPad there and then wait for the new ones to be shipped. But there's a slight problem there. I won't have my iPad for 2 days. What am I gonna do for those 2 days? Use paper music and paper student record and regular metronome? Such a first world problem. So I went with option two, which was to order the new iPad from the store and then drive down to downtown and pick it up from another store. That way I could trade in my old iPad at that store and pick up the new one on the same day. So there won't be any separation from my beloved and hated iPad. So after ordering the new iPad, I drove downtown to another store, but there was a slight problem. Parking in downtown was already hard enough, but I didn't know, or maybe I just forgot, but due to pandemic, lots of restaurants are having all those outside eating pods where parking spots used to be. So now there are even less parking spots. After driving away from the store for about 3 blocks, I found a tiny spot and grabbed it. And when I checked the signs, of course it says loading zone, 20 minutes only. So now the clock is ticking. I have 20 minutes to go to the store and pick up the new one, drop off the old one, and then come back without getting ticket. So I ran about 3 blocks to the store, and by the time I got there, I was sweating and out of breath, and I was telling the person, I have to pick up my new iPad. I was surprised I was able to pass the temperature check. But there was one person ahead of me, and it was taking very long. So I had to be that person and say, excuse me, but I only have 20 minutes. I parked in the loading zone. Can somebody else help me with pickup? Of course, I also added, I don't mean to rush you, by which I meant,
please hurry up.
And they were nice enough to have another person help me, which made me think, why didn't this happen earlier then? But trading in my old iPad at the new store meant there's gonna be another inspection. So my heart goes again, and I was like, please don't notice the screen. And he didn't. I was actually surprised 2 people didn't notice about my screen. So now it's Apple's problem. But if you think about it, it was already Apple's problem. They're the one who gave me the defective product that fails after 3 years. So I don't feel bad at all. Anyway, I successfully turned in my old iPad and got a new iPad and ran back to the car for 3 blocks again, all sweating and out of breath. And I was about 10 minutes after the time limit for the parking, but I didn't have a ticket. So now I have it, new iPad Pro. I only upgraded because I needed to. If my old iPad Pro was working reliably even now, then I wouldn't even have gotten this. But anyway, I have it now. It has thinner merging at the end, so it's a little bit smaller, which I like. But it doesn't have the home button and fingerprint sensor, so you can't unlock with a fingerprint. You will have to use PIN number or Face ID, but good luck with a mask. Oh, by the way, for newer generation of iPad, you will have to get a newer generation of
Apple Pencil 2.
And this is about $30 more expensive. Unlike the old Apple Pencil where you had to stick that thing at the bottom of your iPad to charge or sync, which was terrible design to begin with.
Oh man, I have to charge my Apple Pencil again. Ouch! And what am I supposed to do with this thing?
This is a lot more convenient than old way. But other than that, for me, it does what it used to do. It's just a really nice stylus that's way overpriced. As far as the features go, it really doesn't make that much difference for me. I'm using this iPad exactly the same way I used to use my old iPad. So this was more like a replacement rather than an upgrade. It works slightly faster, which is nice. Of course, the screen is nice and bright and even. And the battery lasts as long as the old one used to when I first purchased it. So there you have it. This is the story of me and my new iPad. I might get a lot of hate comments from Apple lovers, but bring it on. Both good and bad comments are good for the channel. But I really like the design and how it works perfectly and beautifully. I just don't like the price tag. I know this video wasn't as informative as my other videos, but if you still like the story, please hit the like button. If you're thinking about purchasing a new iPad and want the perspective from the musician, my other video is a lot more helpful for you. But I just wanted to share my story with you guys. If you have any comments or thoughts, please leave them in the comment section. And as always, please subscribe and hit the notification button so you'll get notified for my next videos. All right, that's it for today. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.